I'm with Joe Hendy and we're on the AGS stand and we're coming about halfway through two busy days here at the show. How's it been for AGS?
It's been really busy actually. It's been two pretty solid days. It's one of those exhibitions where you're on the stand and quite frankly, there's more people on the stand than you can talk to them on the time. So yeah, it's been really good, I think. It's been a real buzz around the room.
Because, I mean, AGS, how long have you guys been in the scene now? Is it about 5 years, 6 years, something like that?
I would say this is probably the fifth or sixth year. I mean, I've been there 4 years now.
Yeah.
So in January, I've been there 4 years. So I think probably we're coming up to our fifth, maybe sixth season. I think it's five.
Because you've made quite a splash in the time you've been in this industry. You've become an established player very, very quickly.
Yeah. It's about blowing our own trumpets. Yeah, we've grown pretty quick. We're definitely operating at the sort of the elite level of sport, but when you've got a portfolio that sort of backs up, it's an easy thing to do. Obviously, I joined from a previous employer, but the attraction of the whole company was the ethos of having the quality products, and we've got the likes of Sustain, and we're involved with Barenburg Grass Seed. So we're doing a lot of elite level stuff, but at the same time, we haven't forgotten the grassroots. So we can do the whole spectrum, which is, yeah, it's a real string to our bow. And then we've got a good eye to the future as well. So there's a lot of organics, there's a lot of ecological stuff, there's lots of things we're doing now. So when fungicides disappear and, you know, we're a long way down the road of being more sustainable and that sort of thing. So it's nice. It's a nice ethos. It's something I've wanted to get involved for a long time. We're in a good place.
Now, tell me a little bit about the AGS podcast that you're launching.
Well, it wasn't quite my brainchild, but I was heavily involved from the start. So myself, Matt LeBrun, Sam got together and we had the idea of a podcast. And what we wanted to do was deliver a platform for groundsmen, greenkeepers, grounds workers, really, to showcase what they do. It's an opportunity to show and impart their knowledge. And it's never been there's no commercial angle to it at all. It's literally something we can do. It's used in social media, which obviously... social media is definitely the way forward. There's no doubt in that. Back in the day, I doubted the internet would catch on. Obviously, it did. So we're on Spotify. It's called the Turf Up Podcast, and you've got people from grassroots level. For example, I think Groundsman's Wes has
done it. Is it audio or video or both?
It's just at the moment. It's just audio, and it's just done in-house by ourselves. And what we're hitting is from the grassroots level. From the grassroots level, Groundsman Wes did one, up to elite level. Jim Buttar from Twickenham's done one. We've done some overseas stuff with Michael Keith from Ohio State did one. There's a chap called Joe Curtis, used to be a greenkeeper at Gloucester Golf Club. Now he's at Diamond Club, Ottenstein. He's done one. But it's just about, you know, how they get into the industry, what are the industry problems, how they solve it, what's their personal life like. Yeah, it's just a good platform really to sort of celebrate what people are doing.
I'll need to sign up. It sounds very interesting.
No, it's decent. And to be fair, I mean, we've done interviews with all sorts of people. But what we're trying to do is take a cross section of the industry and just promote them really. It's decent. I think we get a lot of feedback. So it's been very well received. Obviously, it's niche. What we do is niche, but. Yeah, it's quite often through Twitter, you might get a DM saying, "I really enjoyed your podcast," from someone that you never met, or you could be at a show and someone will come on, and they're overly familiar, but they know me because this is the podcast. It's kind of but it's quite nice. It's a nice thing. It's nice to know people listening. So we're into season two now. There's going to be a season three, we're sort of looking for people to be on that now. But at the same time, it needs to be interesting. There needs to be a point to it, but yeah, any industry professionals who are interested, they can get involved with the podcast, and we'll have to come along and do it, and yeah, they can tell their story, and yeah, and hopefully we all learn off each other. But yeah, it's been good.
Now, in more general terms, what can we look forward to from AGS in 2023?
Well, I believe a hell of a lot more. It's a company that doesn't stand still. We've got new products. We've got this. Obviously, we've joined forces with Barenburg this year, so we've now got some access to the most elite seed range. Again, I've actually got a meeting later on about next year's seed range. We've got a lot of things going through. Now, I tell you, you can't hide from it. There's the effect of the economy, there's a recession blooming as such, or looming, I should say. and obviously there's supply issues, or there's the cost of living crisis. So we're going to sort of contend with that, but at the same time, we've got plans to sort of try and ride that a little bit. We're looking to work with the customers, and we're trying to work with our customer base to make sure everyone can sort of get through the next 12 months, yeah. 18 months. So we've got some good things in place. I think it's exciting. Full steam ahead, really.
It sounds it. So good luck going forward, Joe. Thank you very much for your time. Good luck with the podcast.
Yeah, thanks very much. I'll get you on, definitely. We'll definitely do one together. That'd be sound.
That'd be great. Look forward to that. Smash
it. Yeah, it's been a good show.
Thanks a lot. Cheers,
Thanks for your time. Cheers, mate.